Good morning students, welcome to online teaching session of Academy Quality School Vegetara once again. Today we will be discussing chapter 3 synthetic fibers and plastics of grade 8 science. In the previous session we had discussed about synthetic fibers, types of synthetic fibers, their properties, advantages and disadvantages. In this session we are going to study about plastics. Plastic is also one kind of fiber. Plastics are one of the most commonly used material nowadays. There are so many things which are made up of plastics. If you will look around yourself, you will find most of the things which we use in our daily life, like even this marker, your pen, pencil box, water bottle, even tiffin box are nowadays available which are made up of plastics, and they look very attractive, and due to that only we are using. Plastics are having some unique properties and due to which they are now commonly used in almost all the field. Plastics are used in housing, automobiles, aircraft, even in the medical industry. If you will see, most of the materials in our house, in medical field, in aircraft, they are made up of plastics. Many medical equipments are made up of plastics. In your house, if you will see, in your kitchen, if you will go, you will see the plastic containers in which your mom keeps so many things. If you will look into your own school bag, you will find that your pencil box, your tiffin box, your water bottles, they are made up of plastics. So let us discuss some of the properties of plastics. Properties. Of plastics. The first property is plastics are non-reactive. Plastics are non-reactive to water and other chemicals. Basically, most of the things are there, materials which react with other chemicals, and due to that they cannot be used in some specific areas. But in case of plastic, they are non-reactive with water, oxygen and with other chemicals, and it is due to this reason only we used to store our food items in the plastics. Pickles are stored in the plastic materials or plastic bottles, and along with that sodium hydroxide, phenolphthalein and some medicines also nowadays they are available in plastic bottles because they are non-reactive. Otherwise, if the reactive substances like metals, if they will be used to store these things, we can see that they will affect the food items and the other chemicals, and they can change their own property, the properties of those chemicals which are kept. But in case of these plastics, they are non-reactive, and due to that, they are widely used to store the things. Number two, the second property of the metal is they are very light and strong. They are light in weight and strong. Now see, these plastic materials are very light in weight, and due to that it is very easy to carry. So we can very easily take the things in our poly bag, plastic bags, and we can move from one place to another. Even the containers which are made up of plastic, they are very light, and it can be taken from one place to another place very easily due to their lightweight. Next is their strength. They are very strong, and due to that they are very durable and long lasting. They are very strong, and due to that they do not break easily. You might have seen that your pens are falling down too many times, your water bottles are falling down, your tiffin box, pencil box, they are falling down, but you will never find any kind of breakage. They are not brittle, they do not break easily. Why? Because they are strong. So these are the properties. Let us discuss some more properties. The third property is they are they can be easily molded. Now see plastics. You might have seen that if the plastics will come near to the heat, if they will be heated, they will start melting. And due to this property, the plastics can be remolded again and again. And due to this reason, it can be very easily recycled also, because they can be melted. So plastics can be melted easily and reshaped. Again and again. So far we have discussed three properties. The first property is the non-reactivity of the plastics. The second is their weight and their strength. They are very light and they are very strong, so that they can be easily carried from one place to another, and they can not break, so they are long lasting. The third property is they can be easily molded and they can be recycled. The next property is they are cheaper and easily available. Plastics are very cheaper. Their price is very less comparative to the other metals which are good quality, but plastics, they are very attractive. They are good looking and their properties are also good, and it's still then their price is very low, and due to that it is very easily bought by us. We use them and they are easily available in the market also. We can find the plastic materials almost everywhere in all the markets. If you will go to the shopping centers also, you can see that most of the things are made up of now plastics, or they are inside the plastic containers or plastic wrappers, because they are non-reactive. Even the chocolates, the food items like biscuits, they are also now wrapped inside the plastic wrappers. Why? Because they are non-reactive, they do not harm the food materials which are present inside them. And they are cheaper also and easily available. The plastic materials are easily available. The next is they are bad conductor. They are bad conductor of heat and electricity. Now see, the plastics are bad conductor of heat, and this is something very good property of plastic, because due to this property only, there are many cooking utensils whose handles are made up of plastics, because they are bad conductor. They do not get hot after cooking for a long time, especially those cookers, pressure cookers and the non-stick cookwares. If you will see that the handles are made up of something black material, it is a kind of plastic. And because the plastics are bad conductor of heat, it do not get hot, and it becomes easy for us to handle that cookers or those utensils, cooking utensils. So this property is utilized here to make the handles of cooking utensils. Next is electricity. Plastics are bad conductor of electricity as well, and due to that only the switches, the plugs and even the electric wires, you might have seen that it is covered with different kinds of plastic, sorry, different colors of plastic materials. The wire, sometimes it is covered with black plastic, sometimes it is covered with red colored plastic, sometimes it is yellow colored, but all those are plastics, because they do not allow the electricity to pass through them, so it becomes easy for us to handle those wires which are covered by plastics. So these are the some unique properties of plastics, due to which they are widespread and they are widely used in almost every field. So let us recapitulate the properties of plastics. The first property is they are non-reactive with the chemicals, water and other gases also, and due to that they are used to store different kinds of chemicals and food items. Second is they are light in weight, and due to their light weight, they can be easily carried from one place to another, and they are very strong, so they do not break and they are long lasting and durable. The third point is they can be remolded, means they will be melted easily after heating them and they can be recycled and remolded again and again. The fourth point is they are cheaper and easily available. Their price is very less, that's why it is very easy for us to buy those things which are made up of plastics, and they are available easily. Everywhere they are available. Next is they are bad conductor of heat and electricity. So plastics are bad conductor of heat. They do not get hot on heating them, and due to that only they are widely used for making the handles of cooking utensils, and they are bad conductor of electricity, and due to which they are used for making the insulation over the wires. Wires, otherwise if these wires will not be coated with plastic materials, we can get shock by using them. This is all about the properties of plastics. Now let us discuss about the types of plastics. I hope you all are writing in your notebook. If you have not opened now, take out your notebook and start writing the things. Make the notes of all the topics. It was all about the types of plastics, properties of plastics. Now we will discuss about the types of plastics. There are two types of plastics. The first is thermoplastic. The second type is thermosetting. Plastics. There are two types of plastics, thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Now see what is the difference. If we will discuss on the basis of the difference, it will be easy for you to understand the concept of the types of plastics. Now see, thermoplastics are soft plastics, like the polythene bags or the carry bags or your water bottles. If you will observe, if you will try to heat them, you can find that they will start melting. Even this marker, if we will talk about, if I will bring it under a flame, over a flame, we will find that it will start melting. This kind of plastics which melt on heating, they are thermoplastics because they are soft. On the other hand, thermosetting plastics, they are very hard. This is the first difference. Means here what I have told is thermoplastics, they can be very easily melted on heating. But in case of thermosetting plastics, they are very hard. They do not melt on heating. So the second difference is they melt. The first point is they are very soft. Thermosettings are very hard. In case of the second one, it melt on heating. Here, they do not melt on heating. They are so hard that even giving a very high temperature, these kinds of plastics, they do not melt on heating. The third is, see, if the plastic can be melted, it means it can be reshaped. Reshaped many times, because they can be melted again and again, and they can be given shapes again and again. But in case of thermosetting plastics, they cannot be melted, so they cannot be given any other shape. They can be shaped only once. Only once. You might have seen that the electric switches or the switchboard, these things cannot melt on heating. The grip, you can ask to your parents also about the grip. You can ask about the MCB. You can look into it. Some of the parts are made up of such hard material which appears like a stone or rock material. But they are nothing, but they are only thermosetting plastics. They are so hard that if you will try to hammer them, they will break like a stone. But they will not melt on heating. Even given a very high temperature also, they do not melt. Now we can discuss some of the examples of thermoplastics. See, plastic bottles. Bottles, pencil box. You can also try to write some examples by your own. Chair, your pen, and this marker, pipes. So many things are there which are made up of plastic. If you will look into your kitchen, you can see there are so many containers which are made up of plastics. So those are actually thermoplastics. You can just remember that if I will heat it, keep in your mind, by the time if you will try to heat those objects, whether they will melt or not. If the answer in your mind will come yes, it will melt, then you can keep it under this category, thermoplastics. Thermoplastics are the only plastics which melt on heating. On the other hand, thermosetting plastics are those plastics which never ever will melt on heating. The examples are Teflon, Bakelite, Melamine, heard about. These Teflon is a coating which is done on the non-stick cookwares. Non-stick cookwares, the outer coating is actually the Teflon. It never melt, and due to that only while using our cooking utensils, non-stick cookwares, it doesn't melt and we can very easily cook our food. Bakelite. Before few minutes we had a talk about pressure cooker. The handles of the non-stick cookwares, which is black in color, and pressure cooker handles, those handles are made up of bakelite. And the next is melamine. The electric switches and plugs, they are made up of melamine. They can never be melted on heating. Now see, these are the two types of plastics, thermoplastics and thermosetting plastics. Now once again we can recapitulate the types of plastics. Thermoplastics are soft, whereas thermosettings are very hard. Being softer, thermoplastics melt on heating, but thermosetting plastics do not melt on heating, even giving at a very high temperature to the objects. Thermoplastics can be reshaped many a times, and due to that they can be recycled also. Thermosetting plastics, once only, by the time when it is made, at that time only, one shape is given to the thermosetting plastics. After that they cannot be given any other shape. The examples of thermoplastics are plastic bottles, pencil box, chair, pen, marker, pipes, and so many containers. You can see some of the covers or the lids, even bottles, medicine bottles are made up of plastics, thermoplastics. Thermosetting plastics examples are Teflon, Bakelite and Melamine. Teflon is used as an outer covering of the non-stick cookwares. Bakelite is used for making the handles of cooking utensils. Melamine is used for making electrical switches. So this is all about the types of plastics. Now let us discuss something more about the plastics. So far we have discussed the properties of plastics, the types of plastics. Now plastics in our daily life is present everywhere. So we can now discuss the plastics in environment, how it is into our environment. Plastics and the environment. Plastics and the environment. Now see, plastics are durable and they are long lasting. They go for a very longer time because they do not degrade or they take long time. They take very long time to degrade. And due to this, if they go into the soil, they do not degrade and they remain in the soil for many years. It is non-biodegradable. So now we can discuss some of the bad effects which it is due to which the plastics are considered non-friendly to the environment. See, plastics nowadays is present everywhere in our daily life. But still, it is non-friendly to the environment. Why? Let us discuss some of the points why it is considered non-friendly to the environment. The first point is they are non-biodegradable. Non-biodegradable. Because plastics are non-biodegradable, due to that, what happens if they will go into the soil? They causes soil pollution. Because they cannot be broken down easily by the microorganisms. So they remain in the soil for a long time and they cause soil pollution. And due to which it affects the life of microorganisms and plants as well which are living in that place. The second point is plastics on burning. They produce harmful gases. Plastics are made up of chemicals. It is completely made up of chemicals. It is a synthetic fiber. Now see, because it is made up of chemicals, so definitely on burning it will produce harmful gases and these gases will cause air pollution. Due to which it can cause various respiratory diseases in the place to those people who are living in that place. Now see, the third point is if the plastic bags or plastic items, if they will go into the sewage, if it will be thrown directly into the sewage or it will be thrown in road areas here and there, definitely with the rain or due to the air, it will get its own way and it will go into the sewage. Now see, on coming into the sewage, what it does? It will choke the sewage. And due to which, what will happen? The water, the dirty water in the sewage will stagnate in one place and it can cause diseases, cause waterborne diseases. Waterborne diseases like typhoid and cholera. Next is, if these plastic items are thrown in the garbage, certain animals are there which take their food from the garbage. Now see, if those animals will eat these plastic materials, it will go into their respiratory system, digestive system, and it will choke their body system. And once if respiratory system will be blocked, the animal will not be able to do respiration and it can lead up to the death also. Now see, the last point is related to the aquatic life. If it will be thrown in water body, it will block the passage of oxygen and carbon dioxide and it can affect the aquatic life. All kinds of aquatic plants and animals, they will not get proper sunlight and oxygen gas as well, and due to which they can not survive properly. So in this way, plastics are harmful for the environment. The first is, plastics are non-biodegradable, so they cannot be degraded by microorganisms and they cause soil pollution. On burning, they produce harmful gases which causes air pollution, due to which it can cause respiratory disorders. Plastic items, if they will go into sewage, they will choke the sewage and cause waterborne diseases like typhoid and cholera. If they are thrown in garbage, it will go into the body of the animals which take their food from the garbage, and they choke their respiratory system and even it can cause death. If it is thrown in water body, it can severely affect the aquatic life. Now, this is all about the bad effects of plastics. Now, we have to discuss some of the ways by which we can decrease the pollution caused by plastics. Some of the ways we can discuss to minimize the pollution caused by plastics. Ways to reduce plastic pollution. How we can reduce the pollution caused by plastics? The first way, or we can say the best way, is to reduce the pollution caused by plastic is to recycle them. The first way is to recycle. After using the plastic materials once, we should not throw it anywhere. It can be recycled, and due to that, instead of throwing it, if we will recycle it, the same plastic will be used again and again, and it will not go into the environment to harm it. The next way is, instead of using plastic bags, we can use jute, paper or cloth bags. If we will be using jute, paper or cloth bags, it will be easy for the microorganisms also to degrade or to decompose these materials, because they are biodegradable and it will not cause any kind of pollution. So in this way also we can decrease the use of plastic. The third way is reuse. Reuse instead of throwing it. Reuse of plastic materials instead of throwing. Because after throwing, it can cause pollution also, and we have to again buy the other plastic material for the making. Again, chemicals will be used in the factories. So better we can reuse the plastic items again and again, so that the pollution caused by plastic will be minimized. And the next is the proper disposal. Proper disposal of plastic is most important part of reducing, most important way of reducing plastic pollution. Now the municipal corporation is providing 2 dustbins of blue and green color. These 2 colored dustbins are provided by the municipal corporation. Now see, can you remember these? For which green color is for biodegradable waste, this green color is for biodegradable waste, and this blue color is for non-biodegradable, like plastic, glasses and metals. And you might have observed that every day people come from the municipality to collect the garbage. So in this way also all this garbage will go in the municipal scrap yard, and then these things are sorted and they can be disposed properly. Because we are also living in the environment, and this is our responsibility also to keep our environment safe from the pollution. The last one is the adopting of 4 R's. 4 R's. What are these 4 R's? Reduce, reuse, recycle, and recover. These are the 4 R's. The point is, we should reduce the use of plastic. Then, if you are using, we should use it again and again. And after that, we should try to recycle it. And at the last, we can find it to recover in something else. So, this is about the ways to reduce plastic pollution. This is all about the chapter. Now, let us take an oath so that we can minimize the pollution caused by plastics. Now, students, listen to me carefully. The assignments related to this topic is already uploaded in the ERP. Please log into it and do the assignments. See you soon. Thank you.